This is such a beautiful equation. There's so much intuition built in here. And there's a few reasons why I love this equation. First, it says that acceleration is just your normal acceleration due to gravity times some multiplier. And then we can think about, well, what is this multiplier? Well, this multiplier depends on the difference of the two masses. If these masses are identical, well, subtracting them will give you zero, and you'll have no motion. Acceleration will be zero, exactly like we expected. If m2 is bigger than m1, well, this will be positive in the denominator. That means we'll have positive acceleration, which we defined as clockwise, exactly what we expected when m2 is greater than m1. Likewise, if m1 is greater than m2, it'll be negative, which becomes counterclockwise. And finally, in the case where, let's say, m2 is much, much, much bigger than m1, let's say m2 was 1,000 kilograms and m1 was 1. 1,000 minus 1, might as well just call it 1,000 and ignore the 1. Likewise, 1,000 plus 1, who cares about the 1? Ignore it. We have the acceleration is just equal to g times m2 over m2. That cancels. Our acceleration is equal to g, 10 meters per second squared. I love that problem. I hope you like it as much as I do. There's going to be a lot more learning to do on the problem set. You are not done here, I promise. But I think what you've done today is really amazing. Good work.